Not a lot of snow locally, but certainly tons of ice.
This with the ice, and it's still up there, limbs continually breaking. It's dangerous.
December 11th, 2008, freezing rain spread over the Capital Region and continued all night and into the next morning, December 12th. Trees, tree limbs, and power lines all buckled under massive ice buildup. Hundreds of thousands of Capital Region residents woke up to no power. People prepared for the long haul as forecasts worsened. Ice melt was in high demand, but spirits were still high.
It's not bad. We got four-wheel drive, and I'm hoping the school buses can all make it to school tomorrow on time.
What's your answer to that?
I don't want to go to school.
He didn't have to worry. School closings began coming in that night, and by the next morning, most kids had the day off.
Albany is closed. North Colony, South Colony, North Warren, Guilderland, Cohoes, Mechanicville, Saratoga, Shen, Schenectady, Troy. You know, the big ones, and everybody else is falling. Yeah.
The shocking scope of the damage became all too real after sunrise, including just how lucky some Latham residents were. A huge tree fell perfectly in between their front yards. Jessica Layton reports.
An ice storm slams the Capital Region, forcing power lines to crash and snapping massive trees in half. But nobody on Taft Avenue in Latham thought it could possibly uproot this enormous 70-foot pine tree.
When you wake up in the morning, you think it's a dream until your reality sets in.
The reality is Bob McCarr didn't get much sleep last night, not after a call from his neighbor. Pat Iannone heard tree branches cracking all night, and she wanted to let him know this one was next.
And half an hour later, I heard the biggest crack I ever heard, and it went. Well, it's a sight. Everybody's going by. I don't think anybody's ever seen anything like this. I mean, it's huge. It's a phenomenon.
As you can see, the length of this massive tree is about the distance in between the two houses. So neighbors here feel extremely fortunate that nobody was hurt or worse, even killed. But there are trees, big trees, all over the place around here, so nobody's breathing easy until the ice is gone. The tree smashed McCarr's brand new car, only 2,000 miles on it, but it missed both houses.
I'm glad it just went this way and not that way, because there's my house over there. It would have downed my house and me.
And despite the mess, they're safe, so they can joke about it.
Well, you know, I got this big saw here, and I'll have this down in about 10 minutes. I'll have this all put away into the fireplace. You know?
With a lot of help.
With a lot of help, yeah, you and the cameraman, my wife.
In the meantime, similar scenes played out across the Capital Region. This man in Niverville, Columbia County, said the damage reminded him of the October 1987 snowstorm, where power was out for days. He worried this would be similar.
Well, after about 2 or 3 days, I'm going to have to go out and get some food and wood to burn.
Many people decided to simply leave their cold, dark homes for a place with power and heat. Shelters opened across the area. A godsend for this senior couple.
I'm 90 years old, never saw anything like this before in my lifetime.
It was terrible, very bitter cold. And for him at his age, we couldn't keep him there.
Then there was this mom with 6 kids.
When you're a mom and you have no power, no heat, you have to get your kids to a safe place. And being that the Red Cross is here for us, we have power, we're warm, it means the world.
Many others in the Capital Region opted for a hotel room, but finding one was easier said than done. Jim Cambrick reports.
Here we are. A room for the night.
Jim and Joan Murray of Old Chatham are among the lucky ones. They were able to get a room at the Holiday Inn Express in downtown Albany, which was offering a blackout special to customers, a room for $79. The rooms here normally go for $119 a night, and the hotel is sold out.
We're just lucky to find a hotel in Albany that had a room, so we're going to get some sleep tonight. We don't know what we'll go home to, though.
Jim, you've been in the house all day. Mighty chilly in there.
Oh, yeah, yeah. It was not too bad this morning, but it got progressively colder and colder, and you can only put on so many sweaters, and at a certain point you say, that's it.
We've had a few people angry. We're trying to help them and make the night a little bit better and do the best we can. But for most part, everyone's just happy to get into the rooms and get settled.
Finding a room has been an exhausting experience for many today. A steady stream of people are getting turned away at front desks everywhere. And by 3 p.m. today, most hotels were booked solid and the parking lots packed. There are 11 hotels along Wolf Road here, and every one of them is full. And Capital Region families are going to be spending some money here. On average, they're going to drop around $120 a night for a room. Add on top of that about $100 a day for food. And if they have to spend a couple of days in a hotel waiting for their power to come back on at home, they put quite a dent in the holiday spending budget. The only ones not spending money on a room are power company workers. National Grid said it has booked 800 area hotel rooms.
In fact, National Grid said it was the largest army assembled in this area in more than 10 years. Crews came from as far as Ohio and Michigan, and they had their work cut out for them, some working 17 hours for 6 days.
We've had to cancel a few Christmas plans already, but we'll do them in January.
Linemen repairing damage in individual neighborhoods were still at the mercy of the big substations. Until those were fixed, their hands were tied.
While those guys are working on the substation issues, we're trying to put up everything we can out here so when they've got power, they can throw a switch and you'll have power. That's the best I can tell you.
Then there was the threat of more wintry weather, including high winds, frigid temps, and snow.
Just be patient. We're doing the best we can do. I mean, we can only do just so much.
Sadly, the storm turned deadly for some people trying to keep warm. Among them, a couple in Glenville in their 60s who started up a portable generator and was found dead.
Police say the generator was hooked up in the garage and wires were running from it into the house, so the door was open just a crack, but that's all it took. The house was completely filled with carbon monoxide.
But having a generator was invaluable if the safety precautions were followed. Mark Mulholland reports.
For John and Joan Fagan, life goes on as usual, even though their Stillwater home lost power early Friday morning.
15 seconds without power.
15 seconds is all it took for their whole house generator to kick on. And it's been running ever since. When most of their neighbors are in the dark, the Fagan's riverfront home is toasty warm, thanks to the propane-powered generator.
Doing everything. Everything works. Dry your clothes, refrigerator works, oven works. I made some cookies. The water pump works, everything. It's worth its weight in gold right now, I'll tell you.
The Fagans' adult children even came from Clifton Park to stay with them when they lost power at their own home.
Well, look at the power company down here.
It's a different story less than a mile away. William and Christine Lane lost power late Thursday night, and they've been without ever since. An old wood stove keeps them warm, but their well pump won't work without electricity, so they're without water and power.
It's been a rough stretch, you know. Without power, it's tough.
The Lanes have begun throwing out perishable food as they hope and pray that their power will be restored soon.
We're trying to make the best of it. That's about all you can do, right?
It took at least a week, but everyone finally got their power back and life slowly returned to normal. Governor David Patterson and Senator Chuck Schumer asked FEMA for emergency aid, and it was granted for several Capital Region counties. They also thanked those who took on the monumental cleanup and recovery.
To all the volunteers and all the workers and all the individuals who at times have been in unsafe environments trying to create power and help those who are been disabled by this unfortunate disaster, we want to thank them all.
In the end, the storm caused millions of dollars in damage and memories that are frozen in time for people who lived through one of the biggest natural disasters in Capital Region history. For more coverage of past news events, head to our News Channel 13 YouTube page and click on News Vault 13. Opening News Vault 13, I'm Rachel Teedy.